Your Excellencies, dignitaries, ladies and gentlemen, I'm very happy to be here, very privileged to have this opportunity. I've been involved in this project for now a little over a year now, and it's really gratifying to see the program take effect. To make you happy, I'm going to make 5 points. 5 points, two reasons. We have 5 minutes, and five is a satisfying number, right? Top five. Point one, I'm going to borrow Paolo's phrase, and this is not something specific to LDCs, but this is unacceptable, and it happens all the time. This is a fairly large South Asian country. It gets its notice for arbitration. The Attorney General, a very sophisticated, highly educated guy, goes on the internet, www.google.com, and puts in, what is a bilateral investment treaty and what is ICSID? This happens with most countries. It happens with developing countries. This is a reality. It should not happen. This is the first challenge that we see in investment law generally. People don't know what they're getting into. My second point, I will recommend the paper that Grant mentioned. You will get a copy of it. It will change your life. It is the voice of a generation with Taylor Swift and Harry Potter. You will like it. It's got a lot of colorful charts, and everybody likes that. Ankta tells us there are 767 investor state cases to date that are publicly known. Of that, 76 involve LDCs. So the number is not a particularly large number. But don't let that make you very happy. That's the second challenge. We are seeing an increased focus in LDCs. We're seeing an increased focus to sign treaties. And I will readily concede, Africa is actually on the cutting edge in this regard. You look at the SADC, you look at COMESA, you look at the East African treaties, it's on the cutting edge of forward-thinking treaties. But we have to see how successful these treaties are with other parties. That's the second challenge. Third, if you look at these 76 cases against LDCs, shocker, the majority of the cases have come from the developed world. I think the statistic says the largest is British investors, 14, then it's French in the US, 7 each, and Dutch, 6. Again, I just want to point, this is the third challenge. We are likely to see this change because the trend today in Africa particularly, is to get greater investment from Asia, particularly China and India. And that is going to lead to a whole new set of issues that is going to come up when we're going to see developing countries in these sort of cases. The fourth point, I'm doing this really efficiently. The fourth point, in the survey of these 76 cases, almost every case has had the LDC bring a jurisdictional challenge, right? I'm just going to give a very quick example. There is a case, I see the representative of the Democratic Republic of Congo here, and this is a case involving the DRC. The issue was whether providing a law firm in the DRC is a foreign investment. You had the original tribunal of three people looking at it, and they said yes. The DRC challenges it, and then you have another three people who look at the same issue and say no. Now, the point that I'm trying to make with this story is, don't give the tribunals this kind of power when you're negotiating treaties. Factor some of these things in when you're deciding the definition of investment or investor. And that takes me to my fifth and final point. This is a recurring theme you see as an argument made by LDCs, but also by developing countries at large. And the argument, I'm going to put colloquial terms, works something like, this is not what we meant when you're interpreting this clause. This is not what we understood. Again, that's problematic, right? If you didn't mean it, you should reflect that in what you're saying. And that is my final spiel for this program. That is why this program is so important, because this program at its heart is going to help build capacities. It is better to avoid problems by knowing what you're getting in, and then you create a more just system, and a just investment system is good for everybody. Thank you very much.